Bien, bonjour à toutes et bonjour à tous. J'ai grand plaisir à retrouver Florence Parly, parce qu'on a pas mal travaillé ensemble quand j'étais jeune journaliste en charge du budget.
Secretary of State in charge of budget under Jospin, the Jospin government. I'd like to apologize because I was involved in a political scandal, and I'd like to apologize because this money could have been used to get rid of a French debt, but what's important is that we had the opportunity to talk together. And I would like to introduce you very briefly. You went to the INA University, 80 year of 87. You were a civil servant in the budget ministry. You contributed to the creation of a CSG tax. You became a member of a socialist party in 1995. I don't know if you're still a member of a socialist party, are you? You can tell me. You were budget minister between 2000 and 2002, and you worked in major companies, Air France and SNCF. And moreover, since the 21st of June, you're the third woman to be not the Minister of Defense, but the Minister Secretary of State to the armies. You replace Sylvie Goulard, who wasn't Secretary of State Minister for long, but she was Minister of the armies too. Now, what's your vision of leadership to dare?
Comment les femmes peuvent-elles oser diriger notamment? Ma première question, c'est ça. Est-ce que ça change quelque chose d'être une femme
à un poste aussi exposé, plutôt masculin,
qui est le ministère de la Défense, qui est de diriger le militaire? Ou est-ce qu'au contraire, paradoxalement, comme c'est un milieu assez à l'autorité
hiérarchique, c'est un changement? Merci.
D'abord, merci d'avoir rafraîchi la mémoire.
Thanks for reminding me. I'd forgotten, but you were the one who was initiated this financial scandal, and it didn't simplify my situation in those days. Yes. And then, is it difficult? Is it more complicated to be a woman who leads this ministry? Well, firstly, I've never tried to be a man, so I don't know what to say. And my second answer is, unfortunately, in my professional life, I've always been in an environment where I was the only woman. So in a way, I'm used to it. Moreover, I believe the military world is used.
Et donc, it's quite traditional. So, il est clair que,
if it's clear,
le chef the boss ou la ministre,
is the minister, be they a man or a woman, well, I believe that they accept this. Could you say that? I'm your boss?
Le chef des armées.
The leader of the armies, the chief of all armies, is the French president. He actually made that quite clear recently, didn't he?
So
I think things are going well. But just one thing I'd like to point out is that things are changing. When I say I'm used to working in a very masculine world,
in
private companies, I had already seen that things were changing quite fast. Why? Well, because society is diverse. Women are quite skilled, diplomas, and their skills are recognized. And on top of that, this is a personal conviction of mine. Some rules, laws, were also adopted in France, like in many other countries, to make sure that women have a place they deserve in society. So what used to be quite exceptional a few years ago is a bit less exceptional, even if there's still a lot to do. And I think that these quotas, as we say, or these obligations, have helped reveal
tout ce dont les femmes sont capables.
Qu'est-ce que vous voudriez changer en tant que femme ministre des armées au sein de
Secretary of State to the armies? What would you like to change in the armies? Maybe
aux femmes soldats qui s'engagent, aux femmes de soldats.
Sensitive touch for female soldiers or soldiers' wives? Who find it difficult, their husbands go far away, they risk their life. What I'd like to help change is the place that women have in my ministry.
It's changed
in companies and things are changing in the armies. I don't think anyone in this room knows that the French army is the fourth most feminine army worldwide.
Now,
things can get better, of course. In our military staff, there are 15% women, and in our civil staff, there are 38% women. But things are improving when we can start seeing women reaching the highest positions. And, well, I haven't had much time to take decisions in just 3 months, but one decision that must be taken is someone who's going to be leading the health service of the army, something that's essential for the good working of our army. And our operations, I am going to appoint a lady at the head of this medical service because this woman was competent, she is competent, but she also was a good symbol. So with the head of staff, I want all women who have a potential to be able to access these responsibilities. And this word potential is really important. One of the major inequalities that exist between men and women in the professional world, not just the armies, actually. Well, quite often, you appoint or you promote a man dependent on their potential, and you promote a woman dependent because of their skills, their tried and tested skills. And we must go on fighting for this. And my responsibility as Army Secretary of State is to raise this difference and to allow women because who have the potential to be in positions that we are perfectly ready for and in which the people will excel. And in the tribune weekly, we created a prize called the Women's Award. We gave it to a woman who's a general. Are you going to have more women generals in your leadership? But I'll always bear this in mind. I'm not going to be like François Giroud and say that today a mediocre woman is appointed instead of a mediocre man because of feminism and moving forward. No, I'm not going to go as far as that, but we have amazing competencies within our armies, so it's quite important for our armies to show this diversity. And I'm actually quite happy every time I go and see troops. I have the opportunity to talk with military leaders. I see that this is a subject that they treat. When soldiers talk about an issue, they don't just talk, they do. And there's something else I believe on in. And that's why I can feel the responsibility of a role that was given to me. There's a question of example we give. Many women still think that some jobs and some responsibilities are not open to them.
So,
those of us who are lucky to be in that kind of position, we have a duty proving that it's possible. It's possible thanks to women's desire to fight, but it's also possible because men make it possible.
So we have some associations, be it in companies
or in the army ministry, whose reason is to promote women. And one thing I'm really attached to is for there to be more than women, but also men. because this women's cause that I defend and I promote will only ever be seen if we have men by our side. And I'm here where I am today in my role because the president and the prime minister wanted it to be so. So we need to play around with this exemplarity that can give women confidence to move forward in their own career, and also think that we need to have men by our side who are convinced of the benefits of diversity.
Une promesse d'Emmanuel Macron de créer un service militaire assez court pour recréer le plaisir républicain et ouvert, bien sûr, à la fois aux garçons et aux filles.
Foster Republican spirit open to both girls and boys. Do you think that can be done? Can be implemented? Is there a budgetary issue?
Je vois vraiment pas pourquoi.
I really can't see why. If our armies have women who fight just like the men do, there's no discrimination. They risk their lives just like men, and they're faced with the same conditions and the same demands as men. So I can't see why this project, whose ambition is to strengthen the links between the army and the nation, I can't see why they exclude girls. No, that wasn't my question. I wanted to know if it would happen. Yes, of course it'll happen. We're working on it, and most likely we're going to implement this national service slowly but surely. It's a major project. It could actually impact several hundred thousand young French people. So before the end of President Macron's term, yes, we will, and we'll probably talk about this, but maybe
alors,
for things, it's coming a bit soon.
Pas de cagnotte, ça, on a cru s'en rendre compte.
And,
mais vous avez quand même un budget qui
annonce to financial malpractices. On a peu de temps, je suis désolé, we didn't have much time. I'd like to apologize because this is a wonderful conversation, really
donc,
interesting.
Je vais
but we have
par
other people
une
who are going to speak, and I'd like to finish with one final
dit, le seul combat perdu d'avant, c'est celui auquel on renonce. Une des choses qu'on m'a demandé de faire en vous interrogeant ce matin, c'est qu'est-ce que vous conseillez aux femmes pour les aider à oser prendre plus de responsabilités, peut-être à la lumière de cette
formule. Ne jamais renoncer elles-mêmes, parce que tout est possible. J'en veux pour preuve que dans les armées françaises aujourd'hui, il n'y a plus un poste qui soit fermé aux femmes. J'ai rencontré récemment
recently, I met a young woman who's going to work on a submarine missile launcher. This is a very difficult service. They can stay up to 70 days underwater. This every job is open to women. And this is an essential moment for our society because we still had this idea.
Il ne faut pas vous dire que tout cela va vous tomber.
We used to have this idea. No longer is in the case. It's not going to be easy.
C'est un combat. Il faut le mener.
It's a fight. You need to carry it out. But you must carry it out, bearing in mind. But it's also up to the men around us to carry it out with us.
Également à toutes les femmes qui sont des mères.
Where I'm calling out to all women who are mothers.
Les garçons que nous éduquons.
We have the boys that we bring up. These boys will be the companions, the partners of our daughters. So let's not bear all the ingredients that mean that nowadays, in our lives, in our professional work, we feel that things aren't done yet. Thank you. Thank you very much, Florence Parly.